Hello everyone, welcome back once again in English video. Today in this video I'm going to take worksheet number 38 in which we are going to do the revision of literature and language, both the portions, alright? Because only this is the last worksheet which you will get before your exams. So I'm trying to complete the things which I was not able to complete in previous videos, alright? So this worksheet will be submitted. Okay, and you will submit this worksheet in on 15th of September. Now, I have given you the revision of both literature and language in this worksheet, and the work are from the both the subjects, lit and lang. But the work you will do in separate notebooks. Suppose the literature work, which I have done in this worksheet, you will do in your literature notebook, and the work which is from your language portion, you will do in your language notebook. Is that clear? I hope this is clear to you all. So now let's see what we are going to do in literature part, what we are going to do revision in literature part. Now in previous video and previous worksheet, we have done the revision of short answer questions and long answer questions. Alright, short answers were from your middle of the chapters, as I have already told you that you have to read your chapters thoroughly for your short answer questions, your tick the correct answer, true false, alright, and fill in the blanks. These all you will get from your middle of the chapter, and also your short answer and long answer questions. The things you have done, the questions you have done in your worksheets, which I gave you for your previous worksheets, will not come as same. Alright, there will be a many difference between your worksheets questions and your exam questions. So for this, you have to study your chapters properly, okay, and you have to prepare in the same way. Now let's do the reference to context. In this revision work of literature, we are going to do reference to context that was left in the previous chapter, previous worksheet. All right. Now, reference to context, I have told you that what do you mean by reference to context? Reference to context means that a paragraph from your chapter which you have studied will come. Okay, it can be any paragraph from your prose or poem. It means prose means the stories you read in your literature, and poems means all the poems, or you can say poem. A stanza can come from your poems, and then you have to answer accordingly, according to that context. Alright, the given questions will be based on the paragraph or context that has been given to you. Is that clear? Now, in this revision portion, I am just giving you the revision of the reference to context from your poem part, from your poem part. Okay, so now, because from prose part, that stories you have done has been done, and you know how to do those question and answers from the chapters, for the reference to context that you get from your chapters. Now here I'm going to give you revision of your poem part. Okay, so now answer the following questions with reference to context. Now first is, this paragraph is, I quarreled with my brother, I don't know what about. One thing led to another, and somehow we fell out. The start of it was light, the end of it was strong. He said he was right, I knew he was wrong. Now read this paragraph carefully. From which poem or poem you can say it has been taken from? If you have read the poem properly, you will recognize the poem, you recognize these lines and sentences or stanza that from which it has been taken. Alright, now that you don't have to write from which, if it is not asked, that from which chapter or poem it has been taken, but just keep this thing in mind, that what have you read in this poem. Now the question is, first question is, with whom the poet had a quarrel? Now the answer is hidden in this portion, in this paragraph or stanza, you can say. You have to give answer according to this para only. I quarreled with my brother. So here's the first answer in the first line only. With whom the poet had a quarrel. Now you will write, answer will be poet had a quarrel with, now here it is written my, but you will change it to her, because here subject we are talking about third person. So poet is, I have told you that the poet of this poem, quarrel, is a female poet. So we will write her. The poet had a quarrel with her brother. B-R-O-T-H-E-R, brother. All right. Next is, what was the reason of a quarrel? Now you have to give the answer that what was the reason why the poet and her brother were fighting. So let's read the stanza again. I quarreled with my brother. I don't know what about. One thing led to another and somehow we fell out. Now here it is asking for the reason. What was the reason of quarrel? But here the second line, read it carefully. I don't know what about. Okay, it means that she did not know that what was the reason for their fighting. They just fell out, or they just fought, or they just quarrel about nothing. So the answer will be, the reason of a quarrel was not known to the poet and her brother. Okay, they didn't know why they were fighting, but they fought. As the siblings do, as the brothers and sisters do, you all are also knowing that why sometimes you fight for no reason. Okay, so in the same way, most of the brothers, sisters, siblings fight without no reason, the poet was also fighting with her brother, and they both didn't know that what was the reason of their quarrel. Okay, so the answer will be, the reason of a quarrel was not known to the poet and her brother. Next is, what phrase means the same as to quarrel? Now let's read the phrase again. Let's read the stanza again. I quarreled with my brother. I don't know what about. One thing led to another and somehow we fell out. The start of it was light. The end of it was strong. He said he was right. I knew he was wrong. Now, the question is asking what phrase. You all know what do we mean by phrase. Phrase and sentence we have done in a language portion. Sentence is a group of words that gives you complete meaning. And phrase is also a group of words, but it does not give complete meaning. Okay, so we have to, the phrase has been given to you that in the stanza, what phrase means quarrel. All right, so we have to find that phrase. So the phrase is, and somehow we fell out. All right, this is the phrase which means quarrel. So you will write, the phrase fell out means the same as to quarrel. All right. Fell out means, this is a phrase because it is a group of words. Okay. There are two words in this, fell out, and it means quarrel in the poem, or you can say in the given stanza. All right. Next is another stanza. This is your stanza number second, and it is from your another poem or poem. Okay, so let's read it. Beauty is heard in the night, wind sighing, rain falling, or a singer chanting, anything in earnest. Now this is a stanza from your poem. Can you recall it? Yes, this poem, this stanza is taken from your poem Beauty. Okay, the two poems are coming in your exam. That is, one is Quarrel and another one is Beauty. So this stanza I have taken from your poem Beauty. Okay, so in the stanza it is saying, beauty is heard in the night, wind sighing, rain falling, or a singer chanting, anything in earnest. So let's take the questions. Where is beauty heard? It's asked that where we can hear beauty. So in the stanza, where it is written, beauty is heard in the night, wind sighing, rain falling, or a singer chanting. So you can write, beauty is heard in the night, wind sighing, sighing, or sighing, you can say wind blowing, and rain falling. Now you can add another two lines also, or when a singer sings a song. Okay, you can write this also, but if it comes in short answer, the question and answers which you get in your reference to context are always in short. But short, remember, short doesn't mean that you will give answer in one word. You have to answer in two or three lines. Minimum one line you will write for the short answer questions. All right. So you have to answer these questions also in short, two or three lines. So next is, how does a singer create beauty? Now, how does singer create beauty, or how a singer shows his beauty? Okay, so a singer chanting. When? Write the answer. A singer creates beauty, B-E-A-U-T-Y, beauty by singing in his melodious, M-E-L-O-D-I-O-U-S, in his melodious voice. Okay, when the singer sings, whether it is a sad song or a song, love song or beauty song, it can be any kind of song. Okay, where does beauty comes from? From his voice. When he sings in his beautiful or melodious voice, it creates beauty. The singer creates beauty. All right, next is, what does the phrase in earnest mean here in the given lines? Now again, phrase, what does this mean? Phrase, where is the phrase? In earnest. Now here it is a phrase given in earnest. So what does this mean? The phrase in earnest means very honestly or sincerely. All right, this is your answer. Now I hope you have learned, you have known that how you will do the question answers for reference to context, how you'll attempt this kind of questions. All right, it is very simple. You have to just read the stanzas again and again, because all the answers are from your stanzas, whether it is your poem part or whether it is from your poet prose part. Okay, answers are all hidden in your given context, given text. Okay, now one thing more, that questions can come like here, the meaning of phrase was given, that find out the meaning of the phrase. You can get questions like, give the meaning of this word directly. Okay, it can be any word. Here the question was, give the meaning of this phrase. You can get the question like, give the meaning of this word, or opposite of this word, or you can get, find out the opposite of this word from the stanza. Means one word will be given to you and you have to find meaning or of that word from the stanza, or the opposite word from that stanza given. All right, so in this way you will get your literature questions. Now in your language portion, let's start your language. Now here also there are 5-6 chapters coming, I think. Okay, so I have given you most of the chapters I have given you for the revision in your previous video. Okay, so I have taken only two questions in this worksheet. Now let's start. Fill in the blanks with the articles. So because there are so many rules in articles, okay, so that's why I am giving you this question again. So, there was dash neighbor of ours who always helped us. Now you have to use articles. Now, if I talk about the rules of using articles, there are so many rules of using a, and the three kinds of articles. All right. A, we use, a and we use, mostly we use for a singular person, place, animal or thing. All right. And the is also used for, you can say, we can use it for plural also and singular also. But we will use if we are particular about something. When we are pointing out something very particularly, we know about whom we are talking, we use the for a single person, place, animal, thing, or for plural also. Alright. So now these were the basic rules. A and we use for singular and plural, and we use according to the sound, vowel sound of the word. Alright. A and an. A we use for consonant sound words, and we use for vowel sound words. Got it? Like if I give you example for A. A we use for consonant. Like I say a boy. So b. Boy is sounding, initial sound is coming off b. So b is your consonant. Alright. So we will use a boy. Alright. But if I say if I say honest man, okay, so honest starts with honest, honest, but we pronounce it o sound comes, h is silent. All right, h is silent, and the initial sound coming from this word honest is o, honest. So here we will use an honest man. We will not use a, we will not see h in the word. It is written h in the starting, we will not see H, but we will go with the vowel sound. The vowel sound is coming of honest, or. So that's why we will write an honest man. Clear? Now, let us take some other rules of using A and an first. Okay. Now, A we use with consonant sound words. Alright. And like if I say 1 rupee note, 1 rupee note. Okay, what I will say, an 1 rupee note or a 1 rupee note? I will say a 1 rupee note because we are writing O N E 1 but pronouncing it as W, 1. W is your consonant sound. It is not your vowel sound. Vowels are A, E, I, O, U. And the sounds come from is A, yeah, A, alright. E we write as A, alright. I, the sound comes E, alright. O sound comes like O, and U sounds come, the vowel sound is, the vowel sound of U is A. We will not say we say umbrella. So umbrella starts with U, but the actual vowel sound of U is A. Okay, we will not read it U. Umbrella, it is not umbrella, it's umbrella. So the actual sound, actual vowel sound of U is A. Okay, so now if I say an umbrella, it is correct because umbrella is starting with vowel sound, A, umbrella. But if I say university, university, it also starts with U, but the sound is not coming vowel. Vowel sound is not coming. It is coming U, university. So we will write A because it is university is starting with a consonant sound. That's why we will write a university. Okay. Next is whenever you write abbreviations, abbreviation means short form of something. Okay. There also, if the vowel sound is not coming, you will not use an, you will use a. Okay. Now, these were your some rules, certain rules using a and an. There are other rules also, but I have given you few only. You can go through the worksheet which I have given to you for many rules if you want to read. Okay. Now, next is the use of the. I have told you the is used with particular person, place, animal or thing we are talking about. It can be singular also. And if you are using for plural things also, person, place, animal, things, particularly they are talking about. Alright? Like if I say the children are standing outside the door. Okay? So we know about which children we are talking. Alright, so that's why we have used the here. Okay, the boy standing at the door is my brother. So, I'm pointing out to the boy who is standing at the door and I know that about whom I'm talking. Okay, so the particular boy I know. So, I will not use a boy standing. I will use the boy standing. Now, these were the two rules of using the. Next is, we use the before superlatives, fastest, tallest, youngest, shortest, best, the best, the fastest, the tallest, the youngest. Alright, you have read the chapter adjectives and its degrees of adjective. Okay, so the third one is, what is the third one? Superlative. So always whenever we are using the superlative degree of adjective in a sentence, alright, we will use the before that superlative degree. Okay. Next is, we use the before the mountain range's name, Himalayas, the Himalayas, like Himalaya is a mountain range, the Himalayas. Newspaper's name, before newspaper's name, we use the Golconda Express, the Indian Express, the Hindustan Times. All right. The is used before the names of rivers, the river, the Ganga, the Yamuna, the Brahmaputra. Okay, and where do we use before the name of famous buildings? All right, these all are, Himalaya is proper noun, river name is Ganga is proper noun, the Golconda Express is a proper noun. All right, these all are proper nouns, but it does not mean that you will use the before every proper noun. Most of the proper nouns, there are some of the proper nouns that they do not need any article. It will not use a, an, or the. Like the, when we are writing the names of people, Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru, alright, Mr. Sharma, we will not use the before them. We will not use the before the name of people. Alright, so let's start the exercise. Fill in the blanks with the correct article. There was dash neighbor of ours who always helped us. Now neighbor is starting with N and also it is sounding, the initial sound is coming of consonant. N is your consonant. Alright. So it will be a neighbor. No. Neighbor. Okay. Next is dash red fort is one of the most famous building of India. Now here it is red fort, it is a proper noun, but I have told you that the is used before the name of famous buildings also. So we will write the red fort. Okay. Next is, it took dash hour to finish. Now here we have to use an article before hour. So hour, we don't say hour, H is silent again here. So we will go with the vowel sound. Okay, initial sound of vowel. It is hour, ah. So we will write an hour. Okay. Next is, this pen cost dash euro. It is euro. Now it is starting with E. Euro is starting with E, which is a vowel. E is a vowel, but when we are pronouncing euro, what sound is coming? The sound is coming of U. Again, just speak out euro. What sound it is coming? U. Your sound is coming. Okay, we are not saying euro. Euro nahi bol rahe hum. Okay, so the sound which is coming, we will focus on the sound of this word. The sound, initial sound is euro. Year, it is sounding, it is starting with year. So we will use a before it, because it is sounding, it is giving the consonant sound. The initial sound is consonant. This pen cost a euro. Got it? Next is, children were enjoying the party. Now, here what we will use, which article we will use? We will use a, an, or the. Now, children is plural, so a or an we cannot use here. Okay, we will use the here because we know that who are the children we are talking about. Okay, we are very particular about those children we are talking here. The children were enjoying. The children were enjoying the party. Next is, my sister is dash student. Now, my sister is dash. This is called abbreviation when you write a group of words in short form. Okay, initial letters. Now, MBA. All right, my sister is doing MBA. Now, the initial word, initial letter is M. M for mango. But what sound is coming? M. The sound is coming of A. So, A is the sound of A. Alright, it is a vowel sound. So, we will write, my sister is an MBA student. In this way you will do. Okay. Next is, today was dash hottest day of this week. Now, today was, this is hottest is your superlative degree we are using here. So, we will use the hottest degree. It's the day of this week. Got it? Now let's see the next question. Next question is, fill in the blanks with pronouns and adjectives where needed. Now you have read about your pronouns. There are different kinds of pronouns. There are personal pronouns, and personal pronouns are of three kinds: first person, second person, and third person. Okay. First person is a person who speaks, or the speaker of the that sentence. Second person, to whom he is, the first person is speaking, and the third speaker is about whom the both first and second speaker are talking. Okay, so these were your personal pronouns. Then there are possessive pronouns, reflexive pronoun, emphasis pronoun, demonstrative pronouns. These are your all kinds of pronoun. Okay, now the most important is reflexive and emphasizing pronouns. Alright, there is a very much confusion when we are using reflexive or emphasizing pronoun. It is very much confusing to identify these both. So, I am giving you the revision that how you will identify these reflexive and emphasizing pronouns. So, what is a reflexive pronoun? Reflexive pronoun, like herself, himself, myself, itself, themselves. Okay, these all are reflexive also and emphasizing pronouns also. But the difference is their use. How, when we use these words in a sentence, their position tells us that what kind of pronouns these are. Okay, suppose I say the boy himself walked home. Okay, so walked is your verb here, and himself is placed before this verb walked. So it means that when this kind of pronouns, himself, herself, ourself, are placed before the verb, these are your emphasizing pronouns. All right. And the second example is, I completed the work myself. Now here, the pronoun myself is coming at the end of the sentence. Okay, so it means that reflexive pronoun is that pronoun which reflects the action done by the subject upon the subject itself. All right. One main point by which you can identify reflexive and emphasizing is that if the pronouns himself, herself, itself, ourself is written at the end of the sentence, or you can say after the verb in the sentence, it is placed after the verb in the sentence, it is your reflexive pronoun, because it is reflecting the work done by the subject itself. All right. The second thing is that emphasizing pronouns are those pronouns which are placed before the verb in the sentence and after the subject. Okay. So these kind of pronouns are your emphasizing pronouns. All right. They emphasize. What does this emphasize pronouns do? They emphasize the action done by the subject. Okay. So let's do this exercise now. He dash organized this party. Now here this in this question you have to add pronouns also and adjectives also. Adjectives, you all know that describing words are known as adjectives. Adjectives describes nouns or pronouns. All right. So adjectives can be beautiful, tall, long, short, any color, quality, quantity. It can be any kind. There are many kind of adjective. I have told you in the adjective chapter that it is adjective of quantity is there, quality is there. All right. It means number, shape, size, color. These all will fall under the category of adjectives. So by these words, we describe any noun or a pronoun. So here in the first sentence, he dash organized this dash party. Now party is your noun. He, here you will use emphasizing pronoun he himself, because he is a male, so we will write himself. He himself organized this. We will write grand. It is telling the grand is showing the quality of this party. It is this grand party. You can also use the word beautiful, amazing. All right. So any word you can use to describe this party. Next is, this is the boy dash brother is a dash poet. Now this is the boy. Now here we will use relative pronoun here, because we are talking about this boy and we are showing the relation of this boy with the object poet. So this is the boy whose brother is a, now poet is again a noun. We have to describe this noun. This poet is a, we can write famous poet. This is the boy whose brother is a famous poet, or we can say great poet. I will write great poet. Okay. So in this way, you have to describe this noun. Next is, I dash wrote this song. So again, here, reflexive or emphasizing, because we have to write a pronoun after the subject and before the verb. Okay, so this is your emphasizing pronoun. I, what will be the pronoun, emphasizing pronoun for I? Myself. Okay, myself. I myself wrote this. Now you have to describe this song, this word song. This beautiful song, you can write, I myself wrote this beautiful song. I myself wrote this short song, long song, or you can write whatever you want to describe about this song. Okay. Next is, she went to that market dash. Now here, she went. Now here, the verb is given. All right, here after the subject. It means the pronoun we have to use will be your reflexive pronoun. Now here it is she. So for she, we will use herself. So she went to that. Now this is market is your noun, place. Okay, we have to write adjective here, because we will write she went to that huge, or you can write big market. I am writing here huge also means big, very big. She went to that huge market, and the pronoun will be herself. It will be your reflexive pronoun, because it is written at the end of the sentence also, and it is reflecting the action to the subject here. Okay. The boy dash is sleeping is my dash friend. The boy. Now here again we will use relative pronoun, because we are talking about dash boy, and we are relating it to the object. The subject, we need to relate the subject with the object. So we will use here relative pronoun. The boy who is sleeping is my You can write a best friend. You can write a naughty friend. I will write here naughty friend. N-A-U-G-H-T-Y. Okay, so I have described this word friend with the adjective naughty. Alright, so I hope you have understood these exercises which I have done today in literature plus language subjects. And you have to do this work in your notebook separately in literature and language. And also you will prepare the Friendly Mongoose chapter from the book A Pact with the Sun also for your term 1 exams. Alright, so till the next video, or not the next video, but this is your last video before your exams. So I hope you all will prepare for exams very seriously. Okay, prepare your exams for you seriously, and I want to wish you good luck for your term 1 exams. Thank you.